Hey guys, I'm Suprabha. In this video, we'll study the examples asked in GATE for the years 17 and 16 for CAC. First example, if f of x is equal to r sin pi x by 2 plus s, f dash 1 by 2 is equal to root 2 and integration 0 to 1 f of x dx is equal to 2r divided by pi, then values of constant r and s respectively are. These are the given options. Now, if you see f dash 1 by 2 is defined, its value is root by 2. So, let us find the derivative of given function and substitute the value of x equal to 1 by 2. F dash x will be derivative of sin is cos. So, cos pi x by 2 and into pi by 2. Here we'll substitute x is equal to 1 by 2, we'll get r pi by 2 cos 1 by 2, that is here we'll get pi by 4. F dash 1 by 2 defined is root 2, we'll substitute that r pi by 2 cos of 90 is 1. Cos 90 is, sorry, that is, it's not cos 90, it's cos 45. So, cos pi by 4 is 1 by root 2. So, we are supposed to find the value of r. This will be root 2 into 2 divided by pi. So, this will be 4 by pi. If we see the options, options C and D are valid because the value of R here is 4 by pi, 4 by 5 that we have already found out. Let us go for finding the value of S. Integration 0 to 1 f of x dx is equal to 2 R by pi. The value is defined, so we will find the integration of given function. Given function is R sine pi into x by 2. This value is defined, it is 2r by pi. Here it is plus s. We will write the integration separately, 0 to 1 into s. Integration of sine is minus cos. So this becomes r minus r cos pi into x by 2 divided by pi by 2 plus integration of constant is x limit 0 to 1. Here also the limits would be 0 to 1. At the left hand side we have the defined value 2r by pi. This will be, if we take it upside down, we will get minus 2r by pi. Let us substitute the value of limits here. Cos pi by 2 minus cos of 0. Here we have, sorry, here it should be s plus s 1 minus 0 is equal to minus 2r by pi. Cos pi by 2 is 0 minus cos 0 is 1. Here we have plus s. So, this becomes 2r pi plus s. So, the value, if we take this term here, the value of s will be equal to 0. Compare these two values, option C is correct. Moving on to the next example, value of limit x tends to 1, x raised to 7 minus 2 into x raised to 5 plus 1. Divided by x cube minus 3 into x square plus 2. These are the given options. Now, if we directly substitute the value of 1 here, we get 1 minus 2 plus 1. At the denominator, we have 1 minus 3 plus 2. So, this becomes 0 divided by 0. If we get this form 0 by 0, we apply the L'Hospital rule. this rule says that take the derivative of the numerator separately and the denominator separately. So we can write limit x tends to 1. Derivative of numerator will be 7x raised to 6 minus 10x raised to 4 plus constant is 0. Derivative of numerator denominator will be 3 into x square minus 3x. Substitute x equal to 1, we get 7 minus 10, 3 minus 6x minus 6. So minus 3 divided by minus 3 becomes 1. So option again C is correct. The last example, value of limit x tends to n 4, sine of x minus 4 divided by x minus 4 is, again we will substitute the value of 4 here. This will be sine of 4 minus 4 divided by 4 minus 4. In the numerator, sine of 0 is 0 divided by 0. Again, the same way that we saw in the previous example, we'll apply the L'Hospital rule. We'll find out the derivative separately. Derivative of sine is cos x minus 4, and this becomes 1. So if we substitute x is equal to 4, we get cos of 0 divided by 1, that is nothing but 1 divided by 1, answer is 1. This is all about the examples Axton gave. Thank you. Thank you for watching my video. Hope you understood the concept. For any doubts and suggestions, please let me know in the comment box. These are few videos that you can refer. Guys, help us to help you. So please like and share my video. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel. Thank you.